I'm Captain Pat with the Kayak Fishing Classics. I wanted to show everybody a little trick that can help everybody gain a little speed and a little ease in their paddling. A lot of experienced kayakers know this, and in fact, that's of course where I learned it from. When you get a new kayak, waxing it makes all the difference. This boat is brand new. It's not been in the water, and initially it feels pretty smooth to you. If you let it heat up in the sun real good and then feel it, you can feel not really a texture to speak of, but you can feel that there's a little bit of almost porosity to it, but it's hard to describe. If you've got a new kayak or clean an old kayak, you know what I'm talking about, but it's just not as slick as it could be. Now, I use Turtle Wax Express Sign with Carnauba Wax, and it's inexpensive. I've been using it now for a couple of years, and it works really good. And it seems to last about 3 months, and depending on how often you use your boat. I always clean my boat, and I use a wash soap on it that's made for kayaks, and it has a wax in it. So it just replenishes it. So this just gives you your first coating, and you want to do this on a day that's not real windy, of course. And just as we set up the film, it got windy. Imagine that. Just give it a good liberal spray, and let it run down a little bit, let it run into places, and then work it in. Your rag initially is going to absorb some of the wax, and then it's going to become pretty useful and actually become an applicator for you. And get a good coverage on this, do a good coat on it. And after you get this on there and you let it dry, you want to buff it out by hand. I just use another one of these shop towels. I don't get real crazy fancy, and I think a small buffer actually takes wax off, and we're trying to build up a coat of it. So I've got a good application on the rag here. We'll let that dry, and then just move down your kayak a little bit. Put your wax on it. And apply some more, and just work your way down your kayak, get it all over wherever the kayak is going to be in the water is where you want to get your wax. This is the new Ocean Kayak Prowler, by the way, that just came out, and we just received this here at the Kayak Fishing Classics for one of our boats, and we're pretty excited about it. And you got to do things right before you put it in the water. Although I was very anxious just to splash it and put it in water, I'm doing it right. You got to wax it up first. I found that it just made a huge difference. Now, on a previous kayaks that I've had that I didn't know to do this, I'd put them in the water and I could feel the drag. And I just thought that's just how kayaks were. And it's not how it's supposed to be. You know, you need to wax it. I mean, they wax airplanes, you wax boat hulls, etc. So you want to get a good wax on it. And I'm not doing anything really hard to do, physically difficult or anything. I'm just lightly rubbing this out and getting it slicked out. And I can feel a world of difference between where I've waxed and where I haven't waxed. So try that. If you have an existing kayak, put it in water, pay attention to how it feels, and then get it out, clean it really good, let it heat up in the sun, and then apply your wax, buff it down lightly, and do it 3 or 4 times, build up a good coat, and let it bake in the sun, and put it in the water, and you'll be amazed how much of a difference that makes. So I hope that helps you out. If you're new to kayaking, or if you've been doing it for years and you just didn't know this, this will help you out a great deal. Hope to see you guys in our tournaments. Good fishing.